Hey, I'm on my way to see Head to Tail Barbecue. He stays in Tuscumbia, Alabama. It's early in the morning now, but I am not going to open this up. This is a GoPro 9. I really wanted to open it up, but if I did, I would have lost track of time and start messing with this. And it's best if I just leave this sealed. But when I get back from this trip, from seeing him, I'll open this up, do an unboxing, and see what it's all about. So, catch you when I hit the road. Let me get packed and get out of here. GoPro, stop recording. Okay, all packed. I have my big green suitcase. Actually, if you don't know about this suitcase, I got that because Randy Santel wheels it on in and has all the stuff nice and neat inside of there, shirts and hoodies and stuff like that. So that is a really great idea. So I had to do that as well. Looks more professional. I need all the help I can get. That's what she's... I'm not even happy to say that. Okay, well, as you can... if you hear the raindrops, it's not birds. It's raindrops. It's raining. I got a package to deliver of masks. So I want to thank Renee. So thank you very much for getting those masks. About to ship that off. I am going to find my towel so I can hide my pew-pew right here. And I got my computer and stuff. I did pack. Yeah, that's my... I didn't take this off the stand to my microphone, my good microphone, so I just rigged the box up like that. So hopefully nothing falls on that and breaks that. But it shouldn't. Okay. Got one pair of underwear. And I'm good. Hey, if through underwear lasts like 4 days. One way this way, then turning around, it's 2 days, then flipping inside out one way, and then that way. That's 4 days you can wear a pair of underwear. You're welcome. I'm a survivor, folks. I'm a survivor. Okay. All right. Well, I'm about to head off. If you didn't know, we're going to Head to Tails in Tuscumbia, Alabama. We're going to go there and do some videos. I'm going to get him to 1,000 subscribers. So please, please find Head to Tail Barbecue. I should put it up on the pinned comment. But I'm telling people that's all I want for Christmas. So if you like to give free Christmas presents out, just go on his page and click subscribe. I'm trying to get him to 1,000 because YouTube will not allow you to use your cell phone to go live unless you have 1,000 subscribers. I think he's up to about 550. So please, please do that for me. Okay. Other than that, I can't wait to go there and do some videos of how to make barbecue sauces. I like to make strange barbecue sauces, you know, like that. But not strange. I guess if you think about it, it might be strange. But if you taste it, it's probably delicious. So that's going to be what I might try to do while I'm there. I might have to pick up some extra items because I think he already went shopping for stuff. I think he's going to do some dry rubs as well on the meat, on the food meat, and. Don't know what to say, but I am making a pit stop for lunch. A man's got to eat. That's what she said. I make a pit stop at, I say Tupelo, because people don't like me saying Tupelos. I'm going to Tupelo, Mississippi. It's Tupelo, okay? Tupelo, Mississippi, to mugshots, to do a mugshot challenge real quick. I think it's like a 15 minute, you have to eat in 15 minutes. I think I do have my personal record's like 3 minutes, I believe. Something like that. But I'm gonna go there, try to go live. So look for a mugshot live. I got round one, round two. Don't look at the round. I think round two was a live. But if you go to Mugshots Tupelo, then you might see a live there. If I get a good signal. So if I get a good signal in there, then I will go live and do that real quick. So okay, well, let me get out of here. So let me hit the road, drop this package off, eat lunch, go meet John from Head to Tail Barbecue. Go post, stop recording.
Wait.
Was bad.
The ones that.
Why are you crossing?
Nice,
oh, no.
Let's send other groups.
Yon, and I appreciate you guys talking.
This is including go. Being lucky. Good morning, Hope.
Good morning.
Good morning, laddie. Flowers. Save 60%.
Is the word.
Saturday afternoon.
When I low, we'll drop down.
Girl, I would dear. Love you. Let me love
you. Hey, I want to let you know, you're going to ask, where's Tasha? Where's Tasha? Well, she is working. She has a real job, people. Real job. Excuse me. She works from home, so she just went to bed, as you know, or you might not know. She goes to bed around 7:45. She gets off at 7:30. She's off at 7:45. So she works nights for FedEx. She does the international hub office work deal. So they did get to work from home. That was a good thing. Her commute to work's like 30 seconds. So that's that. But she is gracious enough to not have a problem with me going doing my job. She's probably partying, because Brandon's gone. Woo! Like, relaxed. But still waiting on the house situation. So one plus of that is she gets to stay there if something's going on with the house, the closing, she can be there and take care of stuff like that. So I'll be back in a few days. And party's over, Tasha. Party is over. Okay. Other than that, I have another 30 minutes to get to Mugshots, and I will update you in the parking lot and smack some food down. GoPro, stop recording. GoPro, stop recording. Okay, made it here about 10 minutes till, so I'm going to wait for the doors to open and then go in. What I'm going to think I'm going to do, I'm going to try to go live on this mugshots, like I said earlier, if they get a good signal. I'm going to use this one as a behind the scenes of what I do to get ready for a challenge and maybe speed it up. And then actually videotape the challenge with this one for a backup camera, just in case the live is a bad signal and stuff like that. And I can fast forward that too in this vlog. But let me get situated, get all my stuff together in this backpack that I need to bring in, and see what happens. So see you inside. Hey guys, I was trying to mugshot challenge out today. Okay guys, I'm gonna go ahead and record on this one. So if this is for my YouTube, then I will go ahead and block the music out. But I'm not gonna have them cut the music out, because there's other people gonna eat here and I don't wanna mess their experience up. So for the live, it's gonna have the music in it, and I'll just not get monetized for it. I won't get paid for it. I'm just doing it because I told everybody I was gonna go live. I'll put another video out without the music and put my own music in for you guys, okay? Excuse me. So we'll talk to you in a second. Let me get the rest of this set up and get started. All right, guys, just got done with the challenge. I'm gonna hit the road in a second, but there's the aftermath right there. If you wanna check out that video, check out the live, but I would definitely check out the live. It went well. So, see you in a little bit. I'm gonna download this rest of this footage and hit the road. While her clothes were drying on the line outside the porch, with that worn out truck and a lot of hope, she left one Thursday morn. Like the storm she came with, never let her go. God knows we didn't have much, but we gave. Hey, I have a story behind this. Molly Schuyler usually did this, like everywhere she went, she had to get out and take a picture of a landmark and post it. So I did it in Ohio over this bridge that I saw her do one at. I said, oh, there's that bridge. So I took a picture and a video for her, and then I left my phone in the car. Freaking broke it. So this is for you, Molly. So if anybody sees this video and watches Molly, let her know. I was thinking about her. She probably already got it. I probably sent it to her phone anyway. But look. Sweet Home Alabama. Maybe you could put that song in too. Okay. Gotta go. That's all I wanted to do. I also had to send her this picture too. Anonymous. I'm looking for a spot that I saw on the road. Roll these windows up. I'm looking for a spot. I saw a sign. Hold on. I saw a sign on the road over there. It's been about 4 or 5 country miles, and I haven't saw the place yet. I don't want to ruin the excitement here. I just don't see it. I keep going and going and going. That's what she said. Well, I'm gonna turn around. I'll show you the sign at the road, but I come to find this place for you guys off the beaten path, and I just don't see it. So if I don't see it in the next half mile, I'm turning around and I'll show you the sign on the road, okay? See you in a bit. Okay, I see it on my GPS, and it was only like 10 seconds after I cut this off. So, whoa, look at that. You don't see this? Didn't think this house would be out here. Okay, we are here. Let me wipe this lens off a little bit. It's still raining, but I've never saw one of these, so I had to check it out. So I'm gonna go down there and see what this is all about. Okay, well, there were some people here paying their respects to their coon dog. So I didn't want to just bother them, and I left. But they have a pet cemetery out here for coon dogs. People grow really fond of their animals that they ran through the woods with, and help them hunt and stuff, and man's best friend. So let me get back on the road, and I got about an hour to drive, and I'll get back to you once I hit the Walmart, because I'm going to hit that Walmart first before I go to Giants. So see you in a little bit. Hey, I know that wasn't as miraculous as you thought, like you're waiting for this big, monumental, fabulous find. Well, for me, my brain, that is. It's something that I haven't saw before, and it's intriguing, and like, hey, what is that? So my mind needs to know. So now it knows, and I'm done. But yeah, that's my ADHD, and Tasha sees that a lot, but it's something that it bothers me until it doesn't bother me anymore. So she said, okay. Well, let me get to where I gotta go, and no more detours, hopefully. Winding through this road, it's like 40 miles to get to the Walmart that I need to get to. But I keep seeing all these nice buildings that I would like to stop at. But gotta keep the path. I gotta keep straight. Well, all through the curves and stuff. It's like 40 minutes to get 20 miles. All right, talk to you guys when I get to Walmart. GoPro, stop recording. Okay, I made it to Walmart. John's house is just like a few miles away. I'll spare you the details of me going in there. I'll put some business cards out. Woo! Freaking bug shots. I just tasted dessert. Woo! Okay, let me get in here and I'll be right back. Good, here we go. Waiting for some barbecue. How's it going?
How's it going, sir?
Don't worry about it. I won't get any apartment numbers. Bam!
I don't care.
There you go. All right.
Need help getting something?
How you doing?
Good.
Good to meet you, man. Nah, well, probably in a second. I'll just say hi, and we'll come out there in a minute and get it.
Okay, yeah. I know it's supposed to rain today. I was talking to my brother-in-law, and he said, yeah, I thought it was coming in tomorrow. But
Yeah. Where we're at, like it's almost every day, but one or two days, and it keeps on spitting all day long.
Yeah.
So,
but, I mean,
look at that. He's already on my good side. He's wearing a shirt. Okay. Well, I just left Walmart. I got a couple snacks. I don't know if you like donuts, like little, there's like a caramel. Everybody wants me to do stuff. We'll snack while we go live later. But if you didn't check that out, check that live out. That probably happened about 2 weeks ago, but check that out. And let me get inside, say hi real quick, and I'll say hi. I've been talking to you the whole freaking time. So let me talk to him. I'll be back with you. All right, guys, I'm here with John. He's better known as Head to Tail Barbecue and Cooking.
Yeah.
I would say Head to Tail Barbecue.
I added that later on because I was like, well, I do more than just barbecue.
Oh, so you changed your name in the middle of your life.
So I added that.
I always say that when somebody changes their name. Like, hey, I've known you as this, now you change it.
Change it up.
Yep. So, I'm here in Tuscumbia, Alabama. I said that right, correctly?
Correct.
Okay. I usually mess everything up. I told people at Tupelo. I say Tupelo and Tasha don't even like that. It's Tupelo, okay?
You know, the NOAA weather radios, they do that. They're like Tupelo.
Oh, do they?
Instead of Tupelo. So it's always funny.
I do stuff to mess with people. You're a lot probably a lot more punctual with your pronunciations than I am. Because I like to actually do things on purpose. So I do it to be funny.
Yeah,
but on his channel, what all do you do? You do restorations, you do the cooking, the barbecue from scratch, and he's holding one right there. What kind is that?
This is my spicy vinegar barbecue sauce. I do have a video on it if you want to check it out, but it's pretty simple. It's just base of apple cider vinegar, and then it's salt, pepper, brown sugar, and then crushed red pepper, and then that's it, pretty much.
Okay. Well, I actually was going to stop by Walmart and get something weird to put, like, a pear. You know, like pear, puree, put it in there, you know, and then make. When I do barbecue sauces, I'm going to, you know, think outside the box and do different stuff. Like a s'mores barbecue sauce, something, you know.
I'll try it.
You never know. You know, like people do the Kool-Aid pickles. You haven't had Kool-Aid pickles yet, right? Mm-hmm. Guess what I got in the trunk? I forgot.
I mean, it's just food.
Yeah, I forgot to, but people do that with Kool-Aid pickles. And there's something else that I just had the Fruity Pebbles on the chili dog that video's coming out. That is different, but it's not bad. But with the peanut butter, that and the chili, I didn't like the peanut butter.
Yeah, I mean, with the Kool-Aid pickles, I just think it'd be more like a different type of bread butter, just flavored wise.
Actually, the apple is actually reminds me of bread and butter. But actually, I like the black cherry pickle the best. The grape looks like olives. If you look at the pickle, it looks like big chunks of olives. And, yeah, the grape makes it look like that. Well, I came here from Memphis, Tennessee. I'm trying to get John here to 1,000 subscribers. Well, 1,000,000 subscribers. Well, we're going to start with 1,000, okay? So YouTube would not let you go live
on my phone.
On a phone. Yeah, you can't on a laptop. It doesn't have a laptop yet. He had one, but you said it was a little antique.
Yeah, 2007.
It needed to be restored. So we're going to try to get him to 1,000 before the end of this year. So I said, the Christmas present. I said, who doesn't like to give a free Christmas present? A free Christmas present to me. What I'm asking is subscribe. Just subscribe to Head to Tail. It'll be in the descriptions. So how long have you been doing YouTube? Like how?
I initially started out just doing stupid stories of what I did.
Like stuff I do every day.
Growing up as a kid, you know, hitting my brother's face with a frying pan, riding the ceiling fan with a hula hoop, and stuff like that.
Well, still kept that on there.
Still on there if you want to watch them and see how stupid I am. And then I was like, well, I like food too. So I started doing cooking, and then recently with the restoration videos with the wood, I was like, well, I enjoy that. So I figured share that with folks as well.
Yeah, I like working with my hands.
I do too. Yeah.
That's what she said. I had to say that because that's what she said. But no, I actually do construction, but now I don't want to say it in a bad manner, but I was trying to get out of construction anyway, but now my tools are gone. So it kind of helped me stop, kind of. I still got to buy, like, hand tools and stuff to build, you know, to work on the chicken coop and do stuff like that. But I don't have to buy specialty floor laying tools and everything else anymore. But I really like doing all kind of stuff, you know. Like, I look at floors all when I don't have low self-esteem. But they think floor layers have low self-esteem because they're always looking at the floor. So, but yeah, I do like doing stuff like that and working my hands, sanding, you know, doing sanding.
I do too.
I'm good at olive body too because I was drunk a lot. And in school, I used to pull the dents out. So, and my teacher said, I give you an A if you can get that looking like it's supposed to. I was in there every lunch hour, everything. I got it going and got an A.
Yeah.
Like, so, but, I've, like on my channel, I started with the cooking. You started with the bad stories and then you went to the cooking. I started with, the eating and now I'm trying to go into the cooking and do my vlogs and stuff like that. So actually the vlogs and then cooking again, but we went to yard sales and I got appliances where I wouldn't burn hers up and I'm doing some different kind of cooking. Like, I'm gonna do some off the wall. So I probably have to do it outside, but I bought two new convection little ovens, you know, and I might cook some ramen noodle soup or some kind of lasagna, something, I don't know. And I'll need an air fryer, but nobody wants to get rid of an air fryer.
Yeah.
If somebody wants to get rid of an air fryer, something's wrong.
We've got one, but it don't work.
Yeah, I'm gonna give you that one. Mine's not gonna work for long, probably, but I'm gonna do different, just something. I'm gonna do my grilled cheese and show them how a real grilled cheese sandwich is supposed to be. And stuff like that.
I'm kind of out there for real cheese sandwich videos. Just haven't done it yet.
You should do one. And like how you do your grilled cheese sandwich. Grilled cheese.
It's going to be like a comparison video. You know.
That's kind of how I want to do it too. So it's just like.
Which one is the best? Like, you know, butter, margarine, or mayonnaise.
Miracle Whip or mayonnaise. Well, you said that. You know, obviously Miracle Whip. But mayonnaise. 99% of the world use mayonnaise because it's cheaper probably. No. But I think it doesn't go as bad as quick too. Yeah. So that's why a lot of restaurants use it. There's some that very few, I mean, I can probably just count one hand around the United States that uses Miracle Whip.
I don't think I've ever been to a restaurant using Miracle Whip.
Yeah. Do you know what a Quick Trip gas station is? It's a just like VP or whatever. It's Quick Trip, QT.
Okay.
Well, they have Miracle Whip packs.
Really?
Yeah, you go in there and just fill your pockets up.
I've never seen it.
Like Sweet and Low, just whoop. But I make sure I get gas there. I don't just walk in the store like, hey.
Ooh, Sweet and Low.
I what's that called? I can't think of the name of it now. Can't even think of it. It wasn't a lie. Mm-mm. I'm gonna chop this out anyway. Bruh, what is that?
I wish I could have you.
When you make it seem like it's okay, it's over the fee.
Validate.
Something like that. It's gonna bother me until I figure it out.
Yeah,
well, I have to come back to that, I guess. Shoot. Huh. And I'm going to talk about something else. It's going to jump in my head later on. I'm like, yeah! Like, what is wrong with that guy?
I remember.
Yeah. Middle of praying or something. I'm just going to jump out. Like, I know what I... So, okay. All right, well, we'll come back to that. I'll try to. Okay. But you do a lot of fishing around here?
Not here. I need to figure out some places. Usually, we fish at the house. We got to
fish at the house. Like, you're fishing. Fishing?
Close enough. You about throw up the... Yeah, but right off her front porch in her front yard, we got almost a 3-acre pond.
Oh, wow. Okay.
So, that's one mile.
That's the hour and a half away, you're saying?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I might get a tent and just go camping.
You come on, man.
Okay.
We'll take you.
All right. It sounds good to me.
It's one of my grandfather, and he built it a long time ago.
Run your line all the way to it, put a bell on it. It's rolling in right there on the porch. If I lived like that, I would rig something up where it would be like that.
Figure it out.
Yep. Well, I would be here, I guess, what's today? Thursday. I got here early so we could do plenty of videos.
Okay.
So we could do video. And what I'm going to do is the vlogs on here. I want to do vlogs. And it's going to be like behind the scenes of you making your videos. So my vlog, I'm still going to talk on it just like this, but you can do your thing. I can just jump over, say something real stupid, and then jump over there. But so we're definitely going to do dry rub, like at least one dry rub, and then a couple. How many like barbecue sauces?
I've got two sauces.
Two sauces, okay. And and we might stop off at Walmart and and get some different stuff for sauces. But and I was thinking about going there to see if you got any new candies or new food out that we can try. Do like a food review or something.
Yeah,
like
we may have some.
And then if it, we can blend it up and make a food barbecue sauce. I don't know. We don't want to waste it. So. Okay, well, other than that, I did want to ask you. You said something about Randy Santel. You haven't been to, he skipped through town and didn't tell you.
No, I missed it. At the Rattlesnake Saloon.
Okay,
so. I pop up on Facebook that he had done it. I was like, well, crap, I missed it.
Yeah, somebody just said that to me in Tupelo. they just told me that I, you still in town? Like, no, I already ate. Like, I'm all gone. I'm in Tuscumbia now. You know, I'm going to be doing the Rattlesnake Saloon. So we're going to get some videos, I would say tomorrow, but I'm lying. Tomorrow will be something else. But the next day after that. So the vlog you're going to see tomorrow, you wait one more day, we'll be at the saloon. And we're going to just try to find some stuff around there and get, you know, more B-roll and stuff. And just and for a vlog, because I'll do the challenge as well. You ever done a food challenge?
Mm-hmm.
No?
Never.
You don't think you, no?
I don't think I can tackle this one.
Okay. Well, I'm not going to tell you to swallow hot dogs because Tasha already told me, she already looked at Anwar when we was at the Whacked Out Wiener the other day because he did that, whoop, when we came back out like a baby bird. And she looked at him, she goes, you don't do that again. So I can't. I can't even ask anybody to do that.
I'm not going
to
do it.
I can't even turn my back and he'll do it. No, I don't even want to go that route. So, okay. Well, other than that, I think we're going to go live here shortly. So I'm going to shut this down before it shuts down on me because it will burn up GoPros, whatever. And I did tell you, I did get the GoPro 9 and I'll have to unbox that when I get to the house. I didn't want to mess with that. That would be a whole nother world. And, I don't even want to get off into that. You see how that one word with the V bothered me. So, save the V! Freaking justification! Tasha, no, I'm going to do that. Justification. It's not even a V in the word. That's why you couldn't figure it out. I would be good on it.
That's why I was like, validate.
Picture, what's that, Pictionary? I wouldn't be good at that.
Or
is that called picture something?
Not Pictionary.
That's another word we got to figure out next off.
Next vlog.
We'll let you know.
Yeah.
No, but
making the sauce. And,
yeah. Oh, I got that. Okay. Well, other than that, is there anything that you want them to know about you? Or I do my 2-hour vlog, so it's like we got all the time in the world to talk.
I just enjoy food, sharing food with folks, and then the woodworking too, share it out. I mean, I'm no professional. I just love to do it, and I do know a little bit of how to do it, but that's about it.
If you don't know, just look like you know.
Yeah.
That's what I say, just look like you know what you're doing.
Or YouTube it.
No, YouTube. I mean, you see that at job sites. And if you don't know what shoring up a building is, you're about to take some support out the middle of the building, so you need to shore up the middle of the building. We was doing an apartment building, 10 stories high. Yes, we done it like once or twice before, but this one here was a bigger magnitude, but then the other guys on the job, you know, they was like, hey, you know, we're talking loud so they can hear us. Like, hey, man, you ever done this before? Like, no, I watched YouTube on that last night. And you'll see the guys that's not even on our crew, you know, they don't even know us. They're like, these guys about to chop this whole thing down and not see on YouTube. It was kind of funny to see their reaction. But they're kind of stupid because they're still under the building. They're like, I don't know if he knows what he's doing or not. I'm like, I'm calling off sick that day. Like drywall day. Drywall, you know what drywall day is? Mm-hmm. You tell them the day after that. Don't tell them the day like you're doing drywall because everybody don't show up.
Be there.
But then they show up the next day. They can't take 2 days off from work. That you know, so you're like, hey, I got drywall tomorrow. And nobody shows up, so you don't really plan too much that day. And then the following day, drywall day, everybody's there. So, you learn stuff.
Yeah.
Okay, well, other than that, it's rain, it's spitting all day, so we're going to find something to do around here and then get to all this live stuff squared away. And please check that out. I think he has some gifts for me, and now I have some gifts for him. He looks like he has more than I brought for him, so I got to go find some stuff outside and bring it to him.
No.
Oh, and I got to show you this too. This is my microphone. It's still on the stand, so I made the box so it did. But I just hope nothing broke this.
Yeah, really that broke off stupid. The legs. Really.
Yeah, I just didn't want to take it apart, so I just put it in this box. There you go, guys. Okay. All right. Talk to you later.
GoPro, stop recording.
He's an amateur. Go ahead. You guys.
GoPro, stop recording.
Okay, guys, I'm going to wrap this vlog up. We went live for like 45 minutes on my channel, and then we went live about an hour and 50 minutes on John's channel. So we are really tired. I'm going to get this computer and stuff put away. I forgot I even had this. This is my other charger I have. You can supposed to jump a car with this. Maybe I should check it out one day and see if it works. But it's trying to finish this vlog up. Okay, guys, good night. I appreciate it. This battery died on here. It's about to die again. So we'll see you guys tomorrow. So thanks for watching the vlog, and I'll talk to you later. Hey, guys, I have hoodies in. The name brand are independent, so you know they are thick and high quality. I'm having them all the way from small to 3X. Only in black right now, so just go ahead and look in descriptions for that. I do have t-shirts as well. The name brand of the t-shirts are Canvas. They are thick, they are soft, the logo wipes off like a bib, just like on the hoodie. So if you want those, please check in descriptions. They all are pre-washed material, so they won't shrink on you. So check in descriptions for the price and the shipping and handling of that, because I do ship in US and in Canada. If you haven't already, hit follow on The Garbage Disposal on Facebook and follow me there to get more pictures and stuff. Please subscribe to my page. Hit the notification bell to get notified of upcoming videos. And hit the like button if you like it. Other than that, please share it with your friends, family, and even your boss. Have a great day and let's make other plans.